Now, we all heard the story about, you know, this laboratory, this Austrian food researchers that basically created beef by taking some cells from cow muscles and growing a hamburger in a petri dish, right? Which sounds pretty disgusting. Well, allegedly, according to some test, this burger was fried up in a pan in London and served to two volunteers, an American food author and an Australian food researcher, and they indicated that it didn't taste that bad. One indicated that I was expecting more texture. Another indicated that it wasn't as juicy because there wasn't as much fat in it. It was a muscle cell, not a fat cell. But they say it tastes pretty good. And they say, you know, it might be a rare tasting burger, but with ketchup and onions and jalapenos or bacon, it's just what McDonald's ordered. Or I guess Burger King or Z Burger or wherever you go to get your burger. I'm not sure about this. I would rather, I mean, I just recently started eating beef. I wasn't a beef eater a couple years ago. I was a vegetarian, then I went and started eating fish and chicken. Now I eat beef every now and then. And I was just in Madison, so I got some really good beef, and some really good bratwursts there. And I'm not sure. I tell you, I would take a beef hamburger from a living cow or a broth from a living cow before a test tube broth any single day of the week. That's all I'm saying. Hey, Fowler Nation, thanks to you, we have made our goal of 1,500 subscribers. You can check out our behind-the-scenes video in the description below this video. But now we need our next goal. We need to get to 2,000 subscribers, and we can't do it without your help. So do me a favor, click that subscribe button, and when we get to 2,000 subscribers, we're going to release a very special video with the Fowler Nation mascot, Larry the Cat.